you've all mostly seen the outside. Have you been inside, and are there any interesting features or things that lend itself or don't lend itself to making it interesting?
And Fran and maybe somebody up in Kathy have all been inside. And I guess the thing that surprised me, because it had been empty for so long, it was in much better condition than I expected it to be. There's a lot to be done, but by some thought, 20 years empty, there'd be, I don't know, vandalism or something like that. That's not true. And some of the original things are that there are some fireplaces that are still intact, and so that part of the restoration.
But it's really been, it was turned into a boarding house for a number of years, and so it's really been cut up on the inside.
Yes.
And so it probably doesn't at all reflect what it looked like when it was first built. And keep in mind, it was built in at least two phases and maybe three. The back part that we're primarily interested in was built in 1853, and then the front part was in the really pretty part was built in the 1870s. And but in terms of where can we find any tunnels or anything like that, we're hoping that we'll be able to do like archaeological studies and things to see if there might be a way to connect it for sure to the underground railroad. But there's nothing obvious that way.
At least sort of we, I often speak for the entire world, we sort of think that finding specific documentation is irrelevant. And for me, I guess because my calling was about all the undocumented freedom seekers, all the undocumented conductors, the free blacks and the whites, the story's never been told and won't be told. So that's really important. Not more important, but as important.
I mean, that is the thing about the house. It's the only thing left of that era. I mean, we know that there were sites all around it.
Changers.
Right, Ford Drive. Right. We know that there were spots, but that's the only thing that's left that links us to that part of our history. And so that's why we think it's important that it should be preserved and that it should tell the story. I mean, there are so many great stories, and there are so many left to be uncovered, because Cleveland was important. I mean, Oberlin knows we all know how important Oberlin was. And Ashtabula has gotten on board and telling its story. And Ashtabula has a fabulous Underground Railroad and anti-slavery history. I mean, there are some great stories out of there. And Cleveland had good, great stories too. And we just need to tell them, and so people will be proud of that. And we'll learn the lessons of the Underground Railroad that still apply today, of what you can accomplish if people work together, if they're brought, if they're willing to put aside whatever differences they have and work on a problem together and stand up for what they believe. So.
We have 5 minutes of now. Parents are tuning in.